Pressure is mounting for the CMC to investigate the business dealings of an embattled LNP backbencher. MP Scott Driscoll has referred himself to the Integrity Commission, who could only advise, not investigate. State political editor Kathy Border reports.
After weeks of refusing to answer questions surrounding his business dealings, LNP colleagues started turning on Redcliffe MP Scott Driscoll.
I think that Mr Driscoll has to clear the air very quickly. If there's evidence here of any misconduct, put it to the CMC and have it investigated properly.
Well, I think all of us would be concerned about making sure that we've got proper financial probity of associations with which we're associated.
A web of connections between Mr Driscoll, his business interests before and after becoming an MP, and his involvement in the Regional Community Association of Moreton Bay. It's a social services non-for-profit group that got $1.6 million government funding last year. There are allegations Mr Driscoll wasn't just a patron, but was directing the group on a daily basis, and his wife is on the payroll.
Over $100,000 of taxpayers' money went to Mr Driscoll's wife.
Have you done anything untoward in business dealings, say, for example, involving IGA?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
How did your wife get her job?
A leaked email showing as controversy was swirling 3 weeks ago, Emma Driscoll tried to delete computer material, worried there will be stuff on there still.
They're murky, they're messy, they're muddy, and a full explanation is needed.
I know of nothing illegal that Scott Driscoll's done. That's all I've got to say about it.
Mr Driscoll released a statement asking for a meeting with the Integrity Commissioner, claiming certain media outlets have a coordinated campaign against him and his family.
I think that will help clear things up.
But the opposition says it's still up to the Premier to ask direct questions and, if need be, refer his MP to the corruption watchdog. Kathy Border, 10 News.